Hello and welcome. If last week the emulation scene started on a high note, this week begins on a more subdued note. While we wait for new updates, let's address some user questions with a video comparing the new NetherSX2 version 1.9 with MyPS2, which has recently been updated on the Play Store. We'll discuss the updates and then showcase the performance of each project. Starting with the NetherSX2 updates, the new build 1.9 is still a development build where the developers are looking for potential bugs before officially releasing version 1.9. So, we'll soon have the final build 1.9. Among various quality of life updates, which I won't list because they are minor, they have updated the widescreen and no interlacing patches, now at the same level as the PCSX2 version for Windows, and integrated the FPS control into the emulator. The emulator now runs the exact frame count as the ROG phone interface. There were also numerous implementations in the game's database. The development team said there were too many to list. Additionally, they decided to create their own control database managed by them. This is crucial because when a control is connected via cables or Bluetooth, it will be recognized and configured automatically without the user needing to configure each button manually. They hope this control database will work better on Android than the version developed for PCSX2. On the MyPS2 side, although there isn't an official change log, the most notable changes include the addition of resolution scaling, now allowing up to 8K if your device supports it, cycle skipping for devices having trouble running certain games, frame rate adjustment to speed up your game if necessary, and nitmap settings. However, not everything is perfect. The resolution scaling has caused issues with ghosts in God of War 2, and since there are no other options, this can only be resolved by the development team. Another issue brought by resolution scaling is vertical lines in Bandai Namco games. There's also no feature implemented to run games without importing them directly into the folders, which takes a lot of time and occupies unnecessary space on the device. Keeping these updates in mind, we compared several games on both projects, focusing on an internal resolution of 3x, which is equivalent to 1080p. The setup used includes a ROG Phone 6 with 8GB of RAM, cooled by an external cooler. The capture was done using a capture card, and the frame rate was locked at 60fps. This means that the results you'll see below are authentic, with no limitations caused by the capture software. If you enjoy this kind of content, don't forget to like the video to help with its promotion. And if you're new here and don't want to miss any updates, consider subscribing to the channel for 2 new videos every week. Let's dive in! Starting with God of War 2, as mentioned earlier, MyPS2 still has ghosting issues, which unfortunately cannot be corrected due to the project's hidden settings. There is also an occlusion issue, causing objects from previous areas to be visible through walls in MyPS2. Additionally, there is higher resource consumption, mainly related to the GPU, which can be up to 20% higher. Since MyPS2 utilizes all GPU resources, there are minor slowdowns, with the FPS dropping from 60 to 40 when there are more enemies or effects on screen. In NetherSX2 1.9, no issues were found. In previous tests on version 1.8, the game didn't run at 60fps in full HD, indicating a significant performance gain in this development version. Need for Speed Most Wanted, despite other content creators managing to run the game on NetherSX2, presented problems on both projects. In MyPS2, besides slowdowns, there are random crashes. In NetherSX2, the game became completely slow on my device, even with low resolution and various different settings. In Need for Speed Underground 2, there were also major issues. In MyPS2, the game displays colors different from the original, but it's possible to run at 1080p, maintaining 60fps most of the time. In NetherSX2, the game exhibited extreme slowdowns and generally low performance, even at lower resolutions. In Shadow of the Colossus, NetherSX2 had an issue I didn't notice during recording. All dust effects were removed without changing any settings, which might give an advantage to NetherSX2 since the PlayStation 2 struggled with multiple transparencies. In MyPS2, the dust effects are present, and the game runs well, although the FPS counter shows 60fps all the time, which isn't true, as the game runs at 30fps most of the time, with drops to 20fps. Finally, in Tekken 5, although it's a game optimized for the system, MyPS2 has errors that PCSX2 had in its 1.4 version, such as vertical lines. In the ice stage, there is slowdown, and the hit effects are missing. I didn't test the treasure room stage, where there was slowdown even on the original PlayStation 2 hardware. In NetherSX2, I didn't notice any graphical issues, except for the minor slowdown mentioned in the treasure room stage. If you want tests on a wider range of games, leave your suggestions in the comments, and I'll evaluate if it's worth making this content. Remember, I'll leave the pre-compiled Nether SX2 build in the description, so you don't have to compile it yourself or risk downloading malware from unreliable sources. Conclusion. It's undeniable that Nether SX2 has superior performance, a broader range of configurations, and delivers great results in most games. However, as we saw in the tests with the Need for Speed franchise, MyPS2 also performed well. That's why it's always advantageous to have two or more projects to switch between when playing your favorite games. Most of the time, you should choose Nether SX2 for its compatibility and accuracy. Although Nether SX2 is no longer receiving updates, there is a team of developers working to decompile the old Aether SX2. If they succeed, we might see all the progress of this great project again. However, this is a complicated task that could take several months or might never come to fruition. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.